Hi, Rushes. I'm Suzanne Hylenski from Mary Poppins, and you're watching Stage Rush TV.
What's going on, Rushers? Happy Thanksgiving, or day after Thanksgiving. Hopefully everybody's stuffed and satisfied from their turkey dinners. I was smart and I filmed this actually before I ate so that I wasn't a disgusting full blob while filming this for you guys. But I hope everyone had a great Thanksgiving. This week I talked with Suzanne Hylenski, who's the dance captain from Mary Poppins, and she had, you know, she has such an intense job as dance captain. I never knew exactly what a dance captain was, and that's why I wanted to find out. A dance captain has to know every single dance step that exists in a show. And especially in a, Mary Poppins is a very dance-heavy show, and it's just the fact that she has to know all those steps and know where everybody is and where everybody's supposed to be. It's really just amazing. You know, I talked to her about one of the show's coolest, the show has so many cool visual effects, and particularly with dancing. You know, I don't know if you, in the second act musical, Step in Time, Bert, the male lead, actually tap dances up the side of the proscenium, and then on the top of it, he's tap dancing upside down, strapped to a harness, and it's really amazing. It's one of the best visual effects I've ever seen in a Broadway show, and I got to talk to her about it, and she had great stories about, you know, what it's like to teach anyone who plays Bert to do that, and that she has had to do it herself, and she said it was like an amusement park ride, and it's lots of fun. So check out that story so you can hear what she says about dancing upside down and all the other craziness that happens with the dance-heavy Mary Poppins. Also, when interviewing Suzanne, I actually got to see Mary Poppins, and even though it's been running for 4 years, it's one of the shows that I actually have managed to escape for 4 years. It's just kind of funny. Never got around to seeing it, but I finally did, and it was definitely quite an experience, and I love going inside the New Amsterdam Theater. I actually was there when The Lion King used to be there years ago. It's such a beautiful theater, and so it was really great to finally see Mary Poppins after 4 years. Now, moving on to the interesting story of Elling, with starring Brendan Fraser and Dennis O'Hare. I saw it last week and really enjoyed it. It's a very simple story, but it's got great performances and a lot of jokes. The audience was really, really feeling the performance when I saw it. Lots of laughs. It was definitely a good audience. And sitting there, I thought, oh, this is going to be a hit. I really was like, this is going to be a hit. I can't predict things well because it was announced today that Elling, after just opening last Sunday, is going to close this Sunday in 2 days. I mean, it was supposed to run through March 20th. Now, listen to some of these numbers. I mean, because obviously the producers felt that this was not going to even last, have strong holiday sales. It sold 78% of its tickets last week, which I would say is pretty strong, but you have to look at the average paid admission price of a ticket. The average ticket price for last week was only $22. So not much money is going to be made if you're only selling an average of $22 a ticket. The show brought in $145,000 last week, and that's just not enough to cover the running costs. But I can't believe that the producers are pulling out so fast and not giving it the chance of the holiday season. I mean, Brendan Fraser is a big star. You'd think people would want to see him, and at least give the show a chance, because it is a pretty strong show, and the performances are great, and the audience that I saw it loved it, so you would think that, you know, the producers would at least give it a little shot to let word of mouth build for the show. So it's very disappointing for Elling, because I thought it was a pretty strong story, pretty strong play. Moving on to some Broadway grosses, Bloody Bloody Andrew Jackson sold 68% of its tickets last week, which I just think is disappointing. A Brief Encounter is selling very strong, almost at the end of its run, selling 77% of its tickets. Chicago was uncharacteristically low last week, selling 55% of its tickets. I'm guessing it'll get a bump with the holiday season come around, because it's such a classic and tourists want to see it. And Fela, you know, continues to amaze me after just celebrating it 1 year on Broadway, still selling very strong with 84% of its tickets. So I hope everyone had a great Thanksgiving and have a great week at the theater.